Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzo. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 14th of December. Indian farmers step up pressure with hunger strike against new farm laws. Pakistan Prime Minister lashes out at opposition, terms Lahore public meeting pathetic amid pandemic. And girls from Nepal's Newar community marry wood apple in traditional Hindu ceremony. And now for all the details. Leaders of protesting Indian farmers observed a one-day hunger strike on Monday against three new farm laws they say threaten their livelihoods, stepping up pressure on Prime Minister Narendra Modi's government to withdraw the legislation. Six rounds of talks between leaders of farmer unions with the government have failed to end the deadlock so far.
Leaders of various Indian farmer organizations who have been protesting for nearly 19 days at national capital New Delhi's borders sat on a day-long hunger strike on Monday against the three new farm laws that liberalize agriculture markets. Hundreds of protesting farmers from northern belt of Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh states sat along in support of their leaders at the Singhu, Tikri and the Ghazipur borders against the laws they fear will lead the government to stop buying their produce at guaranteed prices and leave them at mercy of private players. Farmer leaders said that they wanted to tell the government that their movement was peaceful and would intensify further until the laws are repealed. Six rounds of talks with the government have failed to end the deadlock so far.
कि हम सरकार को ये संदेश देना चाहते हैं कि जो देश का पेट भरता है आज आपकी गलत पॉलिसियों के कारण उसको भूखा बैठना पड़ रहा है.
Meanwhile, amid the ongoing protests, representatives of 10 farmer organizations from various other Indian states met India's Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar in support of the farm laws. Tomar later said the government is engaging with leaders of protesting farmers to decide on the next date of talks to resolve their issues.
Security forces gunned down two Pakistani terrorists and caught alive one terrorist from the encounter site in Durga Poshana area of India's Jammu and Kashmir territory on Sunday. The foreign terrorists were members of proscribed terror outfit Lashkar-e-Taiba. Meanwhile, in another incident, a security officer of a regional party leader who got injured in a terrorist attack on Monday in Srinagar has succumbed to his injuries.
Two Pakistani terrorists of proscribed terror outfit Lashkar-e-Taiba were gunned down and one associate was arrested at Durgan Poshana area in Poonch district of India's Jammu and Kashmir, security officials said on Monday. The Jammu and Kashmir police, assisted by the Indian Army, launched a joint cordon and search operation on Friday after getting information about the presence of suspected terrorists, but heavy snowfall and inclement weather hampered the operations. Finally, on Sunday, the operation was launched and after trapping the terrorists in a cordon, they were eliminated. Arms and ammunition were also recovered from them.
जब काफी देर के बाद उन्होंने इस पे कोई अमल नहीं दिखाया, तो नतीजतन उन्होंने हमारी पार्टीज पे फायरिंग ओपन कर दी, जिसके नतीजे में एनकाउंटर इंस्यू हुआ. ये कल शाम को एनकाउंटर अपने इख्तिताम को पहुंचा, जिसमें दोनों टेररिस्ट जो है वो न्यूट्रलाइज कर दिए गए और एक टेररिस्ट एसोसिएट जो है वो गिरफ्तार किया गया.
Meanwhile, in a terrorist attack in Natipura area of Srinagar, Manzoor Ahmed, a personal security officer of People's Democratic Party leader Parvez Ahmed, who received gunshot wounds, succumbed to the injuries on Monday. The attack comes amid polling for district development councils in Jammu and Kashmir to be held in 8 phases.
In news from Pakistan, Prime Minister Imran Khan has termed the 11-party opposition alliance Pakistan Democratic Movement's Lahore public meeting pathetic and reiterated his long-sworn vow that he will never give a national reconciliation ordinance. The opposition on Sunday urged its supporters to join a march to the capital Islamabad next month to demand new elections and the end to Prime Minister Imran Khan's rule. Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan termed the Pakistan Democratic Movement rally held on Sunday pathetic and reiterated his long-sworn vow that he will never give a national reconciliation ordinance. Taking to Twitter, Khan said, PDM spent so much money, time, effort and displayed utter callousness by endangering people's lives during COVID-19 spike, showing the scant regard they have for citizens' safety and well-being. The leaders of anti-government alliance at the rally in Lahore urged tens of thousands of supporters to join a march to the capital Islamabad next month to demand new elections and end to Prime Minister Imran Khan's rule. They say he was installed by the military in a rigged 2018 election. Former Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif addressed the rally via video link from London and lashed out at the armed forces for its involvement in the political matter of the country.
Yaad rakhe. मेरी बात गौर से सुने कोई फौज अपनी कौम से नहीं लड़ सकती आज जब आप अपनी आजादी मनवा रहे हैं अपने जोरे बाजू से और अपने हकूक हासिल करने पर जोर दे रहे हैं बेकार जाली मुकदमात दर्ज करने के सिवा ये आप का कुछ नहीं बिगाड़ सकते इनसे मत खौफ खाएं क्योंकि ये खुद आपसे खौफजदा है
पाकिस्तान डेमोक्रेटिक मूवमेंट हैज बीन होल्डिंग ह्यूज रैलीज सिंस इट वाज सेट अप इन सितंबर अक्यूजिंग द मिलिट्री ऑफ इंटरफेयरिंग इन पॉलिटिक्स मूविंग ऑन Pakistan's Mutahida Qaumi Movement founder Altaf Hussain has said that the Pakistani army wants to eliminate the Muhajirs while highlighting atrocities against the community in Sindh province. In an address this past week, the exile leader urged Sindhis and Muhajirs to unite for freedom of Sindh from the draconian rule of Pakistani state and its army.
Pakistan's Mutahida Qaumi Movement or MQM founder leader Altaf Hussain this past weekend said that the Pakistani army wants to wipe out the Muhajirs but asserted it will be impossible to wipe out millions of Muhajirs. The MQM founder, who lives in self-exile in London, in a virtual address advocated for the independence of Sindh from the draconian rule of the Pakistani army and called for unity among the Sindhis and Muhajirs, the community of Urdu-speaking immigrants who settled in Pakistan after its formation in 1947.
Jis tarah fauj, ISI, muhajir, tamam bade bade logo ko qatl karne ke baad ab ek ek muhajir ko khatam karna chahti hai, lekin wo ek ek muhajir ko khatam nahi kar sakte. Karon ka mamla jab aa jaye to usko khatam nahi kiya ja sakta.
Activists have long blamed the Pakistani army has killed and displaced thousands of Baloch, Sindhis and Muhajirs in recent years in Sindh and Balochistan region. And these incidents have increased many-fold since the launch of projects as part of the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor.
In news from Afghanistan, Commander of the US and NATO forces in Afghanistan, General Scott Miller, has said he has orders to reduce the US military presence to 2,500 and that part of this is in line with the US-Taliban agreement. This comes as both the Afghan government and the Taliban have exchanged their list about the agenda of the Afghan peace negotiations and confirmed that the next phase of the talks will begin in January.
The commander of US and NATO forces in Afghanistan, General Scott Miller, has said he has orders to reduce US military presence to 2,500 and that part of this is in line with US-Taliban agreement. Miller said the troop reduction will be done in accordance with conditions. The senior NATO official added, foreign troops will still train, advise and assist mission that takes place in Afghanistan. The Trump administration has said that the number of U.S. forces in Afghanistan will be reduced from roughly 4,000 to 2,500 by mid-January. This comes as both sides, the Afghan government and the Taliban, over the past weekend exchanged their list about the agenda of the Afghan peace negotiations and confirmed that the next phase of the talks will begin from January 5.
In news from Nepal, the Newar community in Nepal organized a Bal Vivah, a marriage ceremony over the past weekend in which pre-adolescent girls are married to wood apple as part of a centuries-old tradition. Girls from Newar community are married thrice. They are first made to marry a wood apple and then married to the son before finally getting married to a man.
Girls of the Newar community in Nepal took part in the Bal Vivah, a marriage ceremony in the capital Kathmandu recently, in which girls are married to wood apple as part of a centuries-old tradition. Girls from the Newar community are married thrice. They are first made to marry a wood apple and they marry to the son before finally getting married to a man. The ceremony of Bal Vivah in Nepal is performed when the girls are at pre-adolescence, that is before hitting puberty.
In a TV, Rosa Sola, no, Vana Agadi. You know, your business, your pants, they keep no words of beach, you say. यो जुन यो बेल हुन्छ नि त्यसलाई यो सुवर्णकुमारको प्रतिमाको स्वरूप मानेर त्यो चाहिँ पाँचदेखि यो नौ वर्षको बिचमा यो कन्यादान गरिन्छ
Bal Vivah gives women a right to remarriage even after divorce, which is still considered as violation of social norms and values in some societies. It is believed that a woman who has performed Bal Vivah can never be a widow even if her husband passes away, since she would still be married to the Hindu gods Vishnu and Sun.
An adventure sports festival attracted scores of skiing and snow biking enthusiasts to the picturesque Gulmarg town of India's Jammu and Kashmir this past weekend. The event aimed to promote tourism in the Union Territory, which has been hit hard due to the coronavirus pandemic.
The government in India's Jammu and Kashmir organized a snow biking festival and other adventure sports events in the Federal Territory's picturesque Gulmarg town this past weekend. Gulmarg has always been a popular skiing destination in India. The festival was organized in an extension of events on International Mountains Day and with an aim to promote adventure and winter tourism in the region amid the coronavirus pandemic.
ज़रूरी है सर ये सारी एक्टिविटीज़ करने के लिए क्योंकि एक पॉजिटिव मैसेज जाता है ऑल अक्रॉस इंडिया ऑल अक्रॉस वर्ल्ड कि आप आइए यहाँ पे कश्मीर में स्पेशली गुलमर्ग विच इज़ नोन फॉर यू नो द एडवेंचर टूरिज्म स्पेशली ड्यूरिंग यू नो विंटर्स और अभी तो बर्फ भी बहुत ज़्यादा यहाँ पे हो चुकी है और हो भी रही है करंटली
टूरिज्म इन इंडियाज़ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर इज स्टिल ट्राइंग टू गेट बैक ऑन इट्स फीट अमिड द पैंडेमिक विच हैज़ रिस्ट्रिक्टेड पीपल टू देयर होम्स एंड मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर अवॉइडिंग ट्रैवलिंग due to the fear of contracting the disease. This has brought huge losses to tourism industry in the Union Territory.
Devotees in northern India gathered at the confluence of holy Ganges, Yamuna and mythical Saraswati rivers on Monday to take holy dips on the auspicious day of Somvati Amavasya. On the occasion, devotees worship Hindu god Shiva and Sun for the well-being of their family members.
Hindu devotees gathered at the confluence of holy Ganges, Yamuna and mythical Saraswati rivers dubbed as Sangam in northern India on Monday and took holy dips as they worshipped the sun god to mark an auspicious day. Devotees thronged Sangam on the occasion of Somvati Amavasya, the new moon day that falls on Monday, which is considered very auspicious among Hindus.
Somvati Amavas, हम लोग स्नान करने के लिए आए यहाँ पे संगम में स्नान किया जब किया तब किया सोमवती अमावस का बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण है यहाँ पे संगम स्नान का प्रयागराज में
On Somvati Amavasya, devotees also observe special fast dedicated to Hindu Lord Shiva for well-being of family members. Those who take a holy dip on this day also pay respect to parents who have died. People also distribute food items among the poor and plant saplings in their neighborhood.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter at asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.